We are going to be doing a vegetable bolognese. So we have lots of veggies. I was originally going to do a ground chicken bolognese. And of course, you could do that. You could add all these veggies to the ground chicken. I just chose not to. I actually had ground chicken yesterday for dinner. And I was like, let me just keep it vegetarian today. So first off, I'm going to, my pan's heating up with the heat, and I'm just going to spray the light olive oil in the pan. Okay, get it nice so it's nice and it's a little bit wet, and we could start adding our vegetables. So I do have some fresh garlic. I'm going to pour some fresh garlic in there. I like to add parsley to this recipe, but I was in the supermarket and I actually forgot to buy it. So if you have parsley or dry parsley, you can always add that. I'm going to add some peppers. I'm going to add some celery. Celery is really high in fiber, so that could definitely help lower the blood pressure. I didn't keep the, I kept the vegetable pieces like really, really chunky. So you get them in the, you know, you can actually taste them in the sauce. Right, I'm going to add some mushrooms. And I toasted in the oven this morning. I actually toasted some eggplant, roasted, a little bit of eggplant. I never know whether to keep the skins on. So what I do half and half. I figured I can't go wrong if you do half and half, right?
So yeah, I like the skin. So.
Yeah, some people like it, some people don't. So you know what? I was like, half and half, you can't go wrong. All right, so I'm going to add some salt and pepper. I put a little bit of garlic powder in there as well, although we've got fresh garlic. And I'm going to let that steam up a little bit because this doesn't take long, this salt. It really doesn't. So let that keep going. While that's going, I am going to spiralize some zucchinis. As they call these courgettes in England or France. So we get, this is a different type of zucchini. It's like got a little bit of white and green in it. Now, not everyone has spiralizers. I have one. They're a lot of fun. They're actually like pretty inexpensive. I paid $12 for this one. But if you haven't got one, you can use your potato peeler or you can use your grater. So I'm just going to show you how this works. So you see how it comes out. Going, you get a lot out of it because this is angel hair, this particular rider. I was going to steam it, but it's so light that the sauce will probably cook the zucchini and warm it up straight away.
Oh, that's a great idea.
You know, so look, you have like spaghetti. Now, if you want to use a little bit of whole wheat pasta, you can, and you can actually mix it so you're not eating as much. So there's your you have your spaghetti there.
Beautiful.
Okay, so that's what your spaghetti looks like. Right, I'm gonna stop doing that right now. I'm gonna go back to the thing so it's still sauteing. Right, still needs a little bit more, but once that's done, you're gonna add some crushed tomatoes. All right, please look out for the low sodium because some of these tomatoes in the shops, if you look at the bag, they're really, really high in sodium, and that's really important. I'm actually using Tularosa. It's low in it's a low sodium Tularosa. Just keep that in mind. That's not done yet, so I'm just gonna leave it, but I wanna show you the finished. So there's my finished bolognese. Alrighty.
Like family style, you're right.
Family style, exactly. Absolutely. All right, so the water of the week this week is blueberry and orange. I actually used the sparkling water today. All right, so we have blueberry and orange. Keep hydrated. It's really, really important to keep hydrated. If you don't drink enough water, you feel tired and, you know, just low. But keep your intake of water. My bolognese is ready, so you can see.
Oh, it looks beautiful.
Yeah. So it's got lots and lots of veggies. You can use beans in the bolognese that I've just sent you out today. the bolognese that I did today, if you want to add some white cannelli beans, that's like high in protein, it's like good for you. So if you feel like you want to put some beans in that skinny bolognese, skinny vegetable bolognese, you can.